What's up guys, it's Malady back with my second YouTube video. Now today I'm gonna be making a pencil pouch out of a Ziploc bag. So as you can see, I already started making it because my scissors didn't really work, so I had to get another one. So what you're gonna need is a Ziploc bag, two different types of duct tape. I'm using two. You can use one as the same kind, but I'm using two, and scissors. So the first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna cut like a little part of your Ziploc bag, so you can see I already started, and I'm gonna finish cutting it. You can make a bigger Ziploc bag pouch, but I'm making a little one because I didn't have the medium sized Ziploc bags, so I'm making a small one instead of a big one. So now that I cut this, this is how my Ziploc bag is or looks like. So you're gonna grab your duct tape and you're gonna cut the length that your Ziploc bag is. So my Ziploc bag is this big, so I'm gonna cut the size. And this may take a while. So now that I cut it, you're gonna get your Ziploc bag, and the cut that you opened is gonna, you're gonna put the tape on it. So try to make it as straight as you can so that it wouldn't be so crooked. So as you can see, I put it on, and the excess part you just fold it over. I'm sorry if my bag has hairs because I have dogs, so I'm allowed my dogs come here inside my room and they leave hairs. So this like part right here, you can cut it off because we won't be needing it. And this is how your bottom part will look like for your pouch. So now that you got that, you got your other Ziploc bag, I mean your other duct tape, and you also cut, it depends on your Ziploc bag how big is it. You're gonna cut 3 pieces of your tape. If you have this type of tape, which is like the skinny type, you cut 3 pieces. If you have like the huge one, I think you cut 2 pieces. And you cut it the size of your Ziploc bag. So I cut 1 piece already, as you can see. Now that you cut your piece, you put it onto the Ziploc bag. And you're gonna also do the same for the back part, so you wouldn't see the back part of the tape. But first of all, we're gonna do the front part. It's okay if the tape, like if you cut the tape and you try to make it as perfect as you can to line it up. It's fine if it's not that perfect. Like, for example, what I mean is that you cut your tape and then the shapes are like aligned very well, but I really don't care if they're like not aligned, because it's your own style and you can decorate it however you want. So it's okay if it's not aligned. Okay, now that I got my three pieces of duct tape on the Ziploc bag, what you're gonna do is you're gonna get your other duct tape that you used before, and you're gonna cut the size of this. You're gonna cut it in the size of the Ziploc bag, and you're gonna put it on top of the Ziploc bag. So what I mean is this: so you put it on the Ziploc bag, but like on top of these three. And your bottom. So you're gonna do the same thing to your back side. So these, when you cut your duct tape, you're gonna see that you have these extra little sides. So you can just cut that off. Okay. So you're gonna do that for the other three duct tape pieces that you're gonna put on the back side of your Ziploc bag. So far it's like going well. I just need one more piece of duct tape here, and I need the green on the top. So as you can see, I already got the three pieces of tape on both sides, and the bottom green duct tape on the bottom side, on both sides I mean. And now we just need the top green duct tape on the other side, and we're gonna be done. So now we're done, and you can see how it's turned out. So this is the front side, and this is the back side. So if you open it, you can see that the inside is really good. So this is how the inside is. It's like pretty clear. And that's it for making this Ziploc bag pencil pouch. So I hope you guys like this craft. You guys can make it. I hope you guys do well on making it and enjoyed it. And I hope it's very useful for you guys, because it will be useful for me in putting pencils on pens or my calculator in it. And please subscribe to my channel. This is my second YouTube video, so please subscribe and comment what other video I can do next on crafting, what other craft I can make next. And like this video, get this video to 5 likes, because my first YouTube video I didn't get any likes, so that's sad. And I hope you guys really like this. I hope I get 5 likes for this, because I really enjoyed making this for you guys. So bye.